Introduction. The class develops what is and is not covered by the electric vehicle battery warranty and the implications for fleet management. The electric vehicle battery warranty, battery coverage. The battery is the most important and expensive component of an electric vehicle, so it is important to know what is and is not covered by its warranty. The purchase of a car includes a general warranty, which covers any factory mechanical defects at no cost to the owner. Most brands apply the minimum required by law in each country, which is usually 3 years, although some offer more. However, with the emergence of electric and hybrid cars, manufacturers also offer other additional coverage free of charge with the purchase of the car. The vast majority cover the battery, although some add other coverage and advantages. As with the general warranty, it applies for a period of time in years or mileage. Whichever comes first always applies. The most common warranty for 100% electric vehicles covers manufacturing defects and significant loss of capacity, ensuring that the battery does not fall below a specific threshold, generally 70% or 80% of its original capacity, in the first 8 years or 160,000 kilometers, whichever comes first, from the date of purchase, although this varies depending on the make of the vehicle. Replacement options vary, ranging from replacing the entire battery to replacing specific modules. Some brands offer extended warranty plans to extend battery protection after the original warranty expires, provided that the maintenance requirements specified by the official network of those brands are met. Because battery replacements and repairs are very expensive, it is important to understand the exclusions or conditions that may affect the warranty of an electric vehicle battery. Some exclusions may include, but are not limited to, use of non-standard charging. Any damage caused by the use or installation of non-approved parts. Damage or defects caused by negligence, misuse, overloading, or improper repair by an unauthorized service provider. Damage or defects caused by failure to properly service and maintain the vehicle in accordance with the maintenance schedules and service instructions provided in the owner's manual or on the vehicle's instrument panel, or by failure to follow the instructions provided by an authorized service provider, improper or incorrect repairs. Use of the battery as a stationary power source. Any damage caused by opening the battery coolant reservoir. Damage or failure caused by repairs performed by non-certified technicians. Lifting the vehicle from underneath the battery instead of the designated body lift points. Failure to perform repairs. Using the vehicle for towing and exceeding load limits. Damage caused by attempting to reduce the battery's service life using methods not approved by the manufacturer. Damage caused by flooding. Damage caused by exposure to direct flames. Failure to install essential software or firmware updates. Damage caused by accident. Vehicle vandalism. Improper care or storage of the vehicle. Damage or defects resulting from any transformation or modification of the vehicle not authorized by the manufacturer. Damage or defects caused by using the vehicle during test drives, sporting events, or for purposes other than those described in the driver's manual. Damage or defects due to external mechanical or chemical impacts or other incidents involving intentional acts by third parties, riots, accidents, malicious acts, theft, or unauthorized use. Factors beyond the control of the vehicle manufacturer, such as environmental hazards including industrial waste, storm damage, acid rain, bird droppings, and damage including stone chips, scratches, and the use of inappropriate cleaning materials, ultra-fast charging. It should be noted that in Europe, some manufacturers are beginning to include exceptions related to ultra-fast charging, linking the warranty to limited and restricted use of these charging methods. Implications for fleet management? A study indicates that only 23% of electric car users fully understand the terms of their electric car battery warranty. The duration of the battery warranty and what it covers and does not cover varies between vehicle manufacturers, so before purchasing an electric vehicle for the fleet, it is important to know what the battery warranty covers. As a fleet, and when purchasing large batches of vehicles, it is possible to negotiate with the vehicle manufacturer or dealer to include new coverage or extend the battery warranty period at no cost. For example, if you have your own workshop, you can have battery repairs carried out in your workshop without losing the warranty, or you can have a 10-year or 200,000 kilometer warranty. It is recommended that you purchase vehicle brands with the longest battery warranty and the most coverage. It is recommended to recharge the vehicle as slowly as possible and avoid ultra-fast recharging because the battery warranty may be lost. The state of health SOH of the battery must be monitored at least once a year from the time of purchase, especially when the warranty is nearing its expiration, either by time or mileage. If a battery degrades by 2%, 3% per year, after 8 years it will have degraded by 15%, 25% and may be at the limit of the warranty. It should be noted that the more degraded the battery is, the lower the residual value of the vehicle. To find out the condition of the battery, you can take the vehicle to a specialist or official workshop. The cost varies depending on the workshop and the brand. The workshop will issue a certificate showing the SOH as well as the mileage of the battery and the car. Some brands, via their connected services, offer to generate a battery health certificate. We can perform the diagnosis ourselves with an OBD2 port reader transmitter linked to an app that will allow us to read the battery's SOH as well as a series of additional useful data. It is a small device, fits in the palm of your hand, and costs around $15. It connects to the car's diagnostic port, usually located behind a flap under the dashboard and to the left of the steering wheel. Once plugged in, we will see the battery's SOH on our smartphone, but also how many fast charges the battery has undergone, how many slow charges it has undergone, the mileage the battery has behind it, etc. Some companies that sell these OBD2 readers also offer to provide an SOH certificate. The OBD2 reader can be purchased separately, as they are universal, and then you can choose the app you like best.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as